World News Wednesday. World News Wednesday. Who's the diva of the club? It's made for you and me. DISNEYDIVA. Disney Diva. World News Wednesday. Disney Diva. World News Wednesday. Forever let's hold this banner high, 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 high. Come along and sing a song and join the jamboree. DISNEYDIVA. World News Wednesday. How y'all doing? How y'all doing? It's time for episode 85 of World News Wednesday. Take one. Yeah, we got a lot to talk about, so we got to do our ditty and get down to business. Yeah. So, let's get crack-a-lackin'.
Attaboy, Pinocchio, and I'm going to help you. And any time you need me, you know, just whistle like this.
Like this?
No. Try it again, Pinocchio.
Like this?
No, son. Now listen. That's it. Come on now. Let's sing it. When you get in trouble and you don't know right from wrong, give a little whistle. Give a little whistle. When you meet temptation and the urge is very strong, give a little whistle. Give a little whistle. Not just a little squeak. Pucker up and blow. And if your whistle's weak, yell.
Jiminy Cricket!
Take the straight and narrow path, and if you start to slide, give a little whistle. Give a little whistle. And always let your conscience be your guide. Conscience be your guide.
And always let your conscience be your guide.
Okay. All right. I got a Jiminy Cricket tattoo. I like Jiminy Cricket. And it reminds me to always let my conscience be your guide, because I think a lot of y'all lost some. Not y'all. I think some people have lost their conscience for real. For real, y'all. This world's gone cray cray. All right. No part two. Quick, this has nothing to do with Disney, but please. Hurricane Laura is set to hit Louisiana-Texas border tonight around midnight. If you've been asked to evacuate, please get out the way. Get out. Move. Get out the way. It's going to be bad. It's going to be bad. So please, if they ask you to evacuate, get out. I don't want to hear anything on the news tomorrow besides it was, yeah. Okay, so 8 to 10 inches, or 7 to 10 inches, it could be more in areas. Sustained winds 140 miles an hour and an unsurvivable storm surge. We're all praying for y'all. We are. We're all praying for y'all, but you got to evacuate. Don't hang around. Don't do it. Get out. Storm surge, 15, 20 feet. Come on now. Get out. Okay? Please. Thank you. Yeah. It's going to be bad tonight for Louisiana and Texas, y'all. So, yeah. Please say your prayers. Please. I know a lot of you are. I know you are. So we're going to start off at Magic Kingdom. Finally, you know how they do the caricature silhouettes, not the colored ones, but the silhouette, the black ones, and where they paint the umbrellas, they call them parasols, but they're back at Magic Kingdom. That's nice. And they've added the physical distancing markers for the character cavalcades, because people have been wanting to cluster together. And so now you have to stand on one of the markers to watch the character cavalcade. If not, you need to keep rolling and try to catch it another time. They're always constantly moving up and down. Okay, no word on Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Party, but it should be, they should be announcing it soon. They should be announcing whether they're going to have it or not. We know Halloween party's done. So they should be announcing it soon. I'll keep you up to date as soon as I know something. You'll know something. Yeah. And the Tron Light Cycle Run. Hey, baby. The Tron Light Cycle Run, they're busting the move on it. They're doing the canopy, everything. It's going smooth and it's going quick. And the D-Tech kiosks, where you could have your own phone case or magic band made, they've removed them. And they have this thing called MAD made, where you can go pick up a few things. A lot of the things they've removed, I guess because people touching the screens and this and that. So they're gone. But they should be bringing them back soon. I'll let you know why I think that here when we get to that part. They got a new light up, Happily Ever After Cinderella Castle Cup. A cute cup, it's got a turret on it where the straw comes out. Adorable, I'll get a pic on it as soon as I can on WDWDisneyDiva.com. And y'all, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Yeah, I can go live and be doing all this nonsense. No, it's not nonsense, it's the news. But yeah, I can just go live with y'all instead of having to pre-record it and wait for it to download because it takes forever. It does. Okay, so it's a cute cup, light up cup that it just been spotted at Magic Kingdom, and it's probably going to be going around the parks. And the Space Ranger slushie's back. It's okay. But for $5.99, when it's this hot, it probably tastes really good right now. But it's back. It's back over by Buzz Lightyear Space Ranger Spin. And the Jungle Cruise movie, not the attraction, the movie, has come out with two limited release pins, one of them being the first ever Funko Pop pin. Yeah! It's the boat with the little Funko Pop in it. It's adorable. So those are now available. And the 30th anniversary of Splash Mountain, they did these Sequoia plaques. And they give you a little background on the back about the Sequoia trees. And one's got Brer Bear, one's got Brer Fox with Brer Bear, and one's got Brer Bear with Brer Fox. I think I said that right. I'll post a pic, you know what I'm saying. But they're $600 a piece. Yeah, not a set, a piece. And they only made 500 of each. They didn't want, you know, Sequoia trees take a while to, yeah. So, pick you some up. not me. But yeah, for $600, I'll pass. Animal Kingdom, I did post on this. They started a petition, around August 10th they started a petition, to bring back Flick from A Bug's Life, who's been gone since 2018. They want to bring him back to Animal Kingdom, which I think would be nice. We got our pictures with them, I think it was in 2018 when they had the annual pass holder preview of Pandora. We got to go get our picture with Flick. Now, he didn't have his own character spot. Well, they're saying social distancing with them. You know, you stand there and get your pictures. But he didn't really have his own special spot. You just caught him here and there, and it was really nice. So there's a petition. I put it on www.disneydiva.com on Facebook. So if you want to sign it, you can. If you don't, it's good too. That's about all that's happening in Animal Kingdom. Now, Hollywood Studios, Indiana Jones Stunt Spectacular will now be used as a mobile order wait area, and hopefully a mask relaxation area too, so you can take your mask off and breathe. That'd be nice. But so far they made it a mobile order wait area, and the thing's huge, so they should use half of it for that and half of it so you can sit there and take off your mask and breathe. Okay, y'all, for real, a new Onward Guinevere van has showed up at Hollywood Studios. We're at Hollywood Studios anyway. And it lights up. The headlights light up. It's really cool. The top of the van comes off to take the strap out. And it's got the little unicorn on the strap and everything on the side of it. It's very detailed. I think I got a pickup already on the Facebook page. So they're $18.99. I can't wait to go snag one because we'll be going here soon. Park reservations for annual pass holders are booked all the weekends through November. The weekends through November 7th. So if you're an annual pass holder and you thought you were going to hit the studios, no, not till after November 7th. Unless you can go during the week, then you might be able to sneak in. Yeah. But, yeah. The neon sign for Legends of Hollywood, they already redid the inside. Now they're working on the neon sign on the outside, and they're getting ready to get that finished as well, because it really looks cool at night, the neon sign. And Rise of the Resistance was down last week for a full day, and ever since then they've been having glitches with it, like Kylo Ren's not working one day, and one day they tell people they push back your boarding group, or they cancel it all together. They need to get it fixed. Yes. So hopefully they'll be getting it fixed soon. The glitches. Because, yeah, it was down for a full day and now it's just a glitch here and there. But, a lot of people go to Hollywood Studios just for that attraction. And Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway, of course. Yeah. And Slinky Dog and a lot of other things. But, yeah, they need to get it fixed. Epcot, let's move on over to Epcot, y'all, where the food and wine merchandise will finally be appearing September 1st. Yeah, a lot of cool merch. I did post some pics on WDWDisneyDiva.com on Facebook. And the Doonies look really adorable, but they won't be available till later in September. I'm doing this video twice because this big lizard come running over by me, and I screamed like I was screaming, so yeah, I'm like, let me do it over. And lizards don't usually do that, but I don't want a part two, so yeah, that was funny. That would have been funny to keep it, but I'm like, no. After looking at it, I'm like, let me do it again. Okay, Gateway Gifts at Spaceship Earth has got a new sign after 38 years. Yeah, 38 years, and it looks the same. It doesn't look much different, but they got a new sign after 38 years. It's over by the Spaceship Earth. And speaking of Spaceship Earth, it's been leaking now for, I don't know, a couple years. And at the entrance, when you're walking in, you get a little wet. And now it's gotten worse to where you're really getting wet when you're walking under. So they're hopefully going to be saying they're going to do something with that. Because, yeah, I remember it leaking for a long time. I just thought maybe to cool you off, but no, apparently it's a leak. And Spaceship Earth, fix it, Disney. Now, you know they closed the electric umbrella permanently, but today they filed some permits for a project called Project Gamma, which I'm assuming they're getting ready to do something where the electric umbrella is. I'm sure it's going to be an eating place. Nice. They haven't said anything about 220 lately. I don't know, Space 220 lately. Hopefully they get ready to open that as well. Yeah. So permits is Project Gamma. So electric umbrellas should be hitting up and doing something with that. They're beefing that. Revitalization stuff, y'all. And they also pulled permits for the new show, the new nighttime spectacular, Harmonious. So yes, things are moving right along. This is rolling at other parks as well too. Now, Teppan Edo in Japan has finally reopened, finally, and a lot of people like to eat there. We've ate there once. It was nice. There's other places I like to eat better, but they did open with physical distancing and plexiglass. Yeah, the guy that's the chef that's doing the onions smoke and little rings and makes the Mickeys and stuff. Yeah, you'll still be able to see them, and you're still seated with other people just a few seats down from them. You'll all be sitting around the chef, so that'll be nice that they're back open. Now, they haven't said whether they're cultural reps or not, which I don't think they will be, but they're open back up, so you can make reservations. And let's move over to Disney Springs, y'all, and the regular news around the Walt Disney World Resort. Okay, these new Lego figures have shown up outside the Lego store at Disney Springs. They have Star Wars characters and Frozen. Oh my gosh, amazing. I did post pics on WDWDisneyDiva.com. They have Kylo Ren. They have Rey. They have Chewbacca. They have Anna, Elsa, Olaf, and they're detailed. They're amazing. Go see them before they get faded. Because they do tend to fade. They'll redo them, but they look amazing. Check it out on the page. And next time we go to Disney Springs, we always take y'all with us, so don't worry, don't worry. Now, the void at Disney Springs is now permanently closed. They let the cast members know that they're closing permanently. Yeah, that's not cool. To Disney Plus. We're going to Disney Plus. Once Upon a Time, we'll switch from Netflix over to Disney Plus starting September 18th. Yes, you'll be able to watch your Once Upon a Time on Disney Plus. So if you haven't got Disney Plus and you love Once Upon a Time, I guess you're going to be paying that $6.99. Or the $7.99. I've had it since it came out. They just take it out of my account. I don't know. So yes, Once Upon a Time's moving over to Disney Plus. And they're going to stop running on Netflix. Yeah. So the weekend of Labor Day, they've extended the hours, not for the parks, but they've extended the hours for the resort restaurants and the shops in there. And I'm like, well, let me tell them which ones. And it's pretty much, because not all the hotels are open. So for the resorts that's now open, they're going to extend the hours at least an hour or two on Labor Day weekend, which is not this weekend, next weekend. Yes, 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 yes. So that'll be nice if you're going up there for that weekend. We're going the following weekend, the weekend of the 11th, we're going up. And the Marriott, which owns the Swan and Dolphin, which is on Disney property, has construction's booming on the Cove, which is in between the Swan and the Dolphin. Now, yeah, and they've laid a lot of people off from the Marriott, but they're continuing the construction with the Cove. So that'll be nice. Reflections, we talked about that. Done. There's nothing to see there. They pulled all the heavy equipment out. They stopped construction. They have enough open already. And they're concentrating on getting the attractions and things ready. That's nice. That's good. They don't need another luxury hotel right now. They can put that to the side for a minute. That's nice. And which leads me to why I think they're beefing it up for a reason. Because Disney, not just Disney, but SeaWorld, Universal, all of them had a meeting today with the governor, Ron DeSantis of Florida, to talk about upping capacity. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And he says he's comfortable with it. He's comfortable with them upping capacity. Now, whether they'll choose to do so immediately or not, it's not known yet until they make something official and state that they're going to beef up capacity. But he did offer that it would be safe because they gave them their safety protocols. Said the cast members felt safe, the guests felt safe. You know, they've already explained how they're doing their sanitation and beefing up cleaning and hand washing stations and all that. So he says he feels comfortable with them up in capacity. So that'll be nice. Oh my Lord, I'm sweating. It's so hot out here, y'all. It's brutal. It's hot. So we'll see what happens. As soon as I know, I'll let you know. I'll let you know. Now, at the resort, the Yacht and Beach Club, which is gorgeous, 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 gorgeous. If you get a chance to go stay at that one, go. They're the only resort right now that's open, because remember, they're not all open. Port Orleans, Riverside, and French Quarters are still closed. All Stars are still closed. There's a lot that's still closed. Art of Animation is still closed. So for the resorts that's open, the Yacht and Beach Club is the only one offering in-room food service. In-room food service. My foot's going to sleep. Okay, Shop Disney. Yeah, don't we love some Shop Disney? Don't we love it, y'all, for real? The 90th anniversary Pluto Key in the Pen will be up on Merch Pass September 3rd. September 3rd, if you want to try to score a pin or a key, get on the Merch Pass and snag it. Yeah. Well, you'll see if you get it. Yeah. It depends. But I will tell you something that I found out from a friend who was going on the Merch Pass and kept doing it and doing it and doing it, that no, you can only do it one time. Once you're in and it says that you've been registered for Merch Pass, it'll cancel it if you do it more than once. Now, if you have more than one email, by all means, go in there and do it with your other email. Don't do it more than once from your email you're using, because they'll cancel it and you don't get nothing. So if you want to try to score something, one time, one and done. And if you get it, you get it. If you don't, you don't. But if you do it more than once, you're guaranteed not to get anything. Now, they did show a sneak peek of a 25th anniversary Toy Story key, which looks adorable and detailed. They haven't come out with the dates on that yet. They haven't come out with the dates, but it looks super cute. I'm not a big key collector, but it looks super cute. And some new restaurants to the mobile ordering would be California Grill, Chef Mickey's, Beaches and Cream has been added to mobile order. So you go on your My Disney Experience, your MDE, and you can order food and wait until they tell you it's ready and go pick it up. No waiting. That's nice. Sometimes it's nice to wait, but yeah, they're not doing that right now. Okay, breaking news. Breaking news. Are you ready for the breaking news? I don't know if you're ready or not. I'll make sure I didn't forget anything. If we did forget something, I'll cover it on Yak Attack on Friday when we go live with y'all. Okay, the Milwaukee Bucks. Now, I just found out about this. The Milwaukee Bucks are boycotting the NBA playoffs game at the ESPN Wild Ward Sports Complex because of the shooting of, what's his name, Jacob Blake. So the playoffs, they're boycotting it. Milwaukee Bucks are boycotting it because of the shooting. So there's not going to be an NBA playoff game with the Milwaukee Bucks. Yeah. I don't know if they'll choose somebody else, a backup play team. I don't know. I'll let you know when I know. Now, we talked about, I think it was last World News Wednesday, or on a Yak Attack, about the Equity Union actors made a deal with Disney when they offered the free testing for family and them to come back. Well, Disney hasn't offered it up yet. They did make the deal for them to come back, but they're still working out, I guess, on what they're going to open and what they're not going to open. So, yeah. And so many cast members have been furloughed, so you would think they would want to get back to work as soon as... Now that they said they feel safe, we'll see what happens. But as of yet, nothing. And as soon as I know, I'll let y'all know. I'll let y'all know. So, yeah. No, none of them have been brought back yet. Now, Josh D'Amaro says he's ready to open up Disneyland. As soon as they let him. As soon as they let him, he's ready to open up Disneyland for y'all. That's in that, you know, over by that way. And, but when they do open, you know, the music loops that they play throughout the themed areas, you will no longer hear Zippity-Doo-Dah from the Splash Mountain theme in the loop. They've taken it out. It will be out when Disneyland opens. Now, as far as Walt Disney World Magic Kingdom having it, for now, until they probably get ready to retheme it, and then, of course, it's you know, going to go. But they're celebrating the 30th anniversary. Come on now. I don't like that they did that. Mm-mm. No, I don't like that they did that. Okay, all the rave is still the Halloween merch, because they got new stuff rolling in for Halloween all the time. Every day something coming in. And there's still a lot of stuff that hasn't made it there yet, so it's not, well, you still got more, 2 more months of Halloween, so they're little trickling in little by little, which is nice. And the food and wine merch. The food and wine merch coming September 1st, and later in September, the Doonies. So that's all the rave, because people are talking about, I need this. So yes. That's all the rave. Now, that's usually the last thing I do, but I want to say something real quick about the outlets. The ones in Orlando, I haven't heard anything about the Sawgrass outlet. But word has it from the cast members that have been transferred over to other parks and Disney Springs that they're going to be pulling back between September 4th and September 9th. Which is subject to change. They said you can talk about it, but let them know it's subject to change, and because they're going to try to work it, and there's going to be people up there every day, you know, next week and the week after to see if anything's going on. If they're putting plexiglass up, if they're putting markers up, so as soon as I know, you're going to know, and I hope so. Because I was projecting October after Halloween to get rid of the Halloween merch, but now they got the food and wine. They've already sent half of the flower and garden over to World of Disney at Disney Springs trying to get rid of it. So hopefully Yes, I'd be so happy, y'all, for real. Just a couple things to show. Two of them's not Disney, but I got one's for Disney. This is a collapsible, reusable, stainless steel straw. So it's got its own case, its own little cleaning brush, and it folds down into the case. So yeah, it can extend up to that big. It's got a silicone tip, and it's nice because now all they have is the paper straws, y'all. And I was bringing plastic ones, and that's a lot, you know, to have six or seven plastic straws in there. This, one and done. Yeah, one and done. So yes, I got this at the 7-Eleven, but I think they have them at, you know, other retail places as well. But yeah, that's nice. So you don't have to eat it, because I think it even makes it taste different to me. I don't know, maybe it's just in my head. I'm not sure. And y'all know how I love my Harveys. You know how I love my Harveys. So this is from Harveys. It's not Disney, but it come in this cute little bag, which I say I've done this video once already, but yeah, I screamed like a, yeah, because a lizard was trying to eat me. So this is Callie Bear, and she's scarlet, the color of her is scarlet, and no, she has no eyes and no nose, but it's super adorable, made in the U.S. of A., and nice collector piece for people that collect Harveys. Nice collector piece, because they don't always have them available. It's, you know, they make a certain amount and that's it. You don't get, you know, if you don't get one, then you have to wait until they decide to bring them back. And it's probably not going to be the same colors or yeah. So this is the scarlet. They had a scarlet and a light blue one. I don't remember. And that's a nice little bag it comes in. And I got two of the Harveys newsletters. If anybody didn't get one and you want, it's number two. An issue two of the Harveys newsletter, let me know. I'll hook you up. I got two of them and I already got one, so I don't need those. And one more thing, and I gotta go. I hated having to do that video over, but I'm like, I was looking, I'm like, oh my God, that's hilarious. I screamed like a, yeah. And I made this. Move, ghost. I made this cute little Mickey goat. Well, he's a ghost. He's got his little Mickey hat on, and he's got a little Mickey pumpkin, and Dollar Tree. Super easy, y'all. Super easy. The painting was the worst part. The little fence was, I come a little bag of bones. These were all individual little felt things, and I, you know, you get the rolls of felt there too for, yeah, a dollar. Isn't that cute? So yeah, that's just my things I wanted to show. I'll be back with y'all on Yak Attack Friday. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Call it Favor. So I will see you all on Yak Attack Friday. Oh my Lord, it's hot. Y'all say a prayer for that hurricane named Laura. Yeah, I was like, I got a hurricane named that, but I'm not happy about it now. So y'all in my prayers, and please evacuate if you have to. For real. For real, y'all. And take care. And California, too, with them fires. I was hoping that some of the rain would put you over that way. Maybe it still will. I hope so. So I'll see y'all on Yak Attack, y'all. Mwah. Peace out.